Final topic of the day. Folks, we're going to end with Bitcoin, the cryptocurrency, actually outperforming stocks in the last week. Jeff, you're trading the CBOE Bitcoin futures for us. What's the trade here, and what does it tell us when Bitcoin's outperforming stocks? Is that a good thing?
I think that's a pretty nice cherry-picked stat to utilize. I know Jimmy Yuri or Scott Nation would probably bring up the fact that it's down from where it initially launched in the futures, but I'm going to leave that to the side, Jackie. I want to be a buyer of Bitcoin. All my new friends on Twitter, love you. Thanks for following and hopping on board. But what I go back to, Jackie, is the fact we've talked about weeks here on futures now. We are in a range. We have not seen anything significant. Obviously, the Fidelity news was a big deal. We saw a little boost. But at the end of the day, we are stuck in a range. So I want to utilize and embrace that range. So I want to be a buyer at 6250, looking for a $500 mover higher. And this is the November CBOE one coin contract, looking for a target of 6750. However, if that $6,000 level, that line in the sand, which has been wonderful support, gets violated, that's where I'm getting stopped out of this trade. But play the range.
What do you think, Chris? Do you want to play the range here to the upside?
You know, Jackie, I'm actually short this from a trade I did last week. And Jeff, you're going to make half of Twitter Nation happy with Bitcoin. You're going to make the other half unhappy. Because I know when we put out these trades, we get it from both sides
unhappy.
Right now. Exactly. But, Jackie, I'm short at 63.5. I have my stop in at 68.5. This is a trade going back to last week. Mm-hmm. I still have that trade on right now. You know, saying that this market is up $25 when the stock market is down 300 points isn't much for Bitcoin. I would think that there'd be a lot more into it. I mean, look at gold prices over the last couple of weeks. We've rallied $30-$40 in that. Bitcoin has hardly rallied in the big sell-off of the market or the uncertainty of the market. So I don't think, I don't think that's an alternative to the markets right now. In fact, I think it's just another bad news headline, and then we start
waiting
heading
to happen
lower again.
Potentially.
Exactly.
Jeff, punch back. Tell us why short-term you think we could really see that spike despite the point that Grizz makes.
Well, I don't have any headline for you. We're not seeing the ETF get approved or anything like that, but I think it goes back to what little technicals we have on this futures contract, right? We haven't even been trading this a year. But if you look at this chart, it's really spent a lot of time in price discovery mode in between 6250 and 6750. Therefore, this trade that I'm presenting right now could work out and Grizz could still be in his trade. So we're both kind of playing the range here, which is very interesting. So yes, we're opposed, but we kind of, at the end of the day, come in and do a little man-hug at the end.
All right.
We both could be right.
You could be.
We both could be right.
And then I will make sure that man hug happens in person. You can't just put that out there and, not follow up. So, all right, let's get the risk reward on this one. Jeff is buying the CBOE Bitcoin futures 6250, targeting a move up to 6750 each contract here, a little bit more than 6,000. So he's risking $250 to make double that on the trade.